Okay, that's the worst sneak song.
I want to do the eyes for
that. All right, here we go. We each get 5 cards, random words written on them. They're in order. Now, our goal is to work these words into the conversation as casually and as seamlessly as possible. You up for this?
I am up for this.
Great.
And we have not looked at these words.
I have not seen these words.
I have not seen these words.
All right, very good. Just make sure you're going in order, because I think there's probably Chiron so the audience can see what the words are.
Okay.
Simply, you'll go first. Now, we've already talked about Alexander and the terrible, horrible, no good, very bad day. But can you tell me about one of your worst days?
On a camping trip with my family, my family and I went moose watching. And we really did. And we drove out. It was in Canada. We drove out in the middle of nowhere.
Uh-huh.
And we sat in a darkened forest for 6 hours waiting for a moose to appear. Because my mom wanted to see the moose.
And did you finally see one?
No, we did not.
What did you see any animals at all or any wild things? I mean, did you see like any like different? You're in the woods, right?
Yeah.
So things are growing around plants, vegetation. Mm-hmm. You'd see a fern. You'd see a zucchini. You'd see the things growing in the forest.
We didn't see a zucchini.
Yeah.
The problem with it was the fact that we weren't dressed properly for moose watching, for zucchini finding.
No.
I, for one, had the wrong kind of pantaloons on.
Excuse me?
You brought up in a barn?
You
I had the wrong kind of pantaloons.
You didn't have the camping ones that you would normally wear.
I did not have the outdoor pantaloons.
You didn't know.
Or the French pantalon.
Oh, yeah. How's your... This is a separate thing. I'm going to go a little bit off topic.
Sure.
How's your salamander?
Which one are you referring to? Terry or Marcus?
Marcus.
Okay.
Yeah, that's the one,
Marcus is doing okay. Terry's fine. Anderson Cooper.
How many salamanders do you have?
I just have 3.
Okay, yeah.
Anderson Cooper is molting.
That's the very white salamander.
Very, very yes. White.
Hey. The white salamander.
Yeah. Hey! Boy, do I know what you're talking about.
Yeah. I was just doing the fonts.
I know you do.
Yeah, yeah.
I love the fonts.
You do?
Yes.
Do you grow up watching a lot of TV and a lot of...
I watched a lot of TV, a lot of Fonzie, and I... I laugh because I'm thinking about something.
Yeah. I assume
you
that.
Think about watching old-time TV and all the commercials that you watch on TV. You know, commercials for peanut butter.
Yep.
I love the Jif commercials.
Oh, you do?
No, what I especially liked is when they mixed it with the marshmallow. What was that thing called?
Marshmallow fluff?
Yeah, but there was the sandwich itself. It was a, Oh, that's right, it was a fluffernutter. Weren't those delicious?
I used to eat them all the time.
Me too.
I used to eat them all the time and at school, and we just get it, and we would eat them together like as almost like a little club, and we called it our friend zone. And we'd just sit in our friend zone,
yeah,
and just eat pumpernickels all day long. I'll never forget that.
It made me laugh even hearing about it. I wasn't there, but yeah. The way you tell that story makes me wish that I was there.
It's a great story.
I like a lot of foods.
You do?
I do. I love to eat. I love to eat foods that are tasty and have a special treat to my palate.
Yeah, you do.
Especially certain kinds of fruits. You know, fruits are really good for you.
Yeah. Is that right?
They are.
They are. There's like different types of fruits are like apples, bananas, mm-hmm, pears.
Yeah, other ones too.
Yeah.
The more exotic ones.
Oh, you're talking about pineapple, kiwi.
Yeah, even more so. What's What's the name of that? What's the name of that one?
Starfruit.
I guess this isn't really the game, but it's kind of fun.
I can't keep...
I know what I'm thinking.
Guess the fruit is another game that we play on the... on the show. It's after hours. This is for the web show. But the fruits are good for you because you got to stay in shape.
Right.
And you got to make sure, like, doesn't all the fatty foods just go, you know, straight to the pelvis.
That's true.
Straight to the pelvis right there. Did we do all of them?
Well, no, it won't go straight to the pelvis. It's when you come caught.
How can you fit that in there? Thanks for watching our video. Click over here for other videos, and click here to subscribe, and click here for an intense dance party.